so much of my life happen around fucking Graham stuff, dude.
Used to get Utz potato chips here for band practice. Holy smokes, Eric and Jake looked right up here. This was, what fucking bar was that? Shit. We played here a few times with Holy Smokes. We had a great game. Here it was. But, it was not Easy Lover or something else. It was Dark or something else.
Where Jake and Eric live right here. This apartment was dope. It looks like they totally redid the front and the lettering and the paint and everything. They renovated it, maybe.
Was there always a bar right here? I suppose there probably was. Fuck, there was probably some other kind of building across the street. It's gone now. This, I mean, you know, now it would be insane to have this apartment. You know, it was fucking dope, you know, in retrospect. It was really amazing, the recording setup they had here, the Nintendo 64. It's a great time in our lives, you know? Holy smokes. In New York, like we're the fucking Strokes or whatever. I'm kind of freaking out. I'm feeling my life flash before my eyes here. Life that could have been. Remember sitting on that bench over there. Remember smoking a joint over here. City just keeps going up. Oh God. So I just had an epiphany in the
I was in this, like, it was like a vintage store, I guess. It's a thrift store. It was kind of like a flea, but it was kind of like an antique store. Like, you know, they had all these old TVs and shit. Stuff that used to be in the thrift store, now it feels like antiques. You know, like old typewriters and shit. Used to be junk, now it's like $180. And my mom was always going to thrift stores. And my grandma was always going to antique stores. She was always going antiquing. I guess that's maybe an old person thing. Do thrift stores just turn into antiques over time? Is that just the circle of life? In any case, God damn it. I just did a whole thing about Weezer. Because I found all the Weezer content in the store immediately. there was an ivory telephone in the window. That's why I went in. Because I was like... There was this ivory telephone in the window. One of those old kind of... And then, so I go in the store, I pick up this magazine. It's Gene Simmons' Tongue magazine. And it's like from 1999, maybe 2000. And it's just all the douchebags of rock, circa... You know, it's like Fred Durst is in it talking about Woodstock 99. Tommy Lee, of course, is in it talking about some kind of sex thing, some kind of sleazy hookup or something. And then I flipped to the back. Donna DeJerico, I think, was in it. There was like a Donna DeJerico. Or was that... It was some chick from Baywatch. Something about, you know, going to some porn convention. And then, lo and behold, in the back of the magazine, I'm flipping through... Who peeks out at me from a corner of the fucking spread, but none other than our friend Rivers Cuomo, circa Maladroit. So I guess this would have been like 2002 or 3. It was like when Scott Strainer had just joined the band. So it was an article about Rivers has like this kind of fuzzy goatee thing. So, you know, it was kind of trying to show their edgier side. It says Weezer gives good shred. And it's like all about how their bassist went insane. Mikey Sharp, I guess, went crazy. And so then they got Scott Schreiner. And he's like, yeah, he had a grill and he had tattoos all over his body. I knew he was the guy immediately. Like, you know, to Weezer fans, that was a kind of a puzzling choice. They're like, what? But it does kind of make perfect sense. If you look at the long arc of Weezer, Scott Schreiner is kind of the perfect choice. For what Rivers Cuomo really wants to do. So, anyway, that was Gene Simmons' Tongue magazine, the cutting edge of journalism, circa 2002. Rivers Cuomo, he is everywhere. He's among us.
Hey, he was 2001 Man of the Year.
What do you
got
to do?
Documenting for the archive for posterity.
And he was like, oh, he's like, yeah, you know, people around here don't like Trump. And I'm just like, yeah. And then, like, I'm not going to ask. You're an idiot about that. Also, we have a discount at my job.
For the next 22 hours, you will participate
in an honor.
It started on just one television station in 1966. And this year, more than 100 million people will join.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Easy Paradise Labor Day Telethon. Oh, baby, the stars are going to come out tonight. You better believe it, we are live here from Long Island City, Queens, New York, Manhattan, right there, baby. There it is. All that money, all that power, all that celebrity. We are the stars. We are the artists. The culture is here. We've got Claire Donahue. Claire Donahue. We've got Vic Callahan. Mohammed Patel might make an appearance. Amelia Bearsmith is in the house. We've got Breaking Objects. We've got Underground in the house. It's going to be fantastic. Sinja and more. And more, and more, and more. It's just going to be so much entertainment. It's going to be so much fun. We're going to raise so much money.
Rip Taylor, Randy Travis, The Venture.
I'm going to start out with a long poem, okay? So,
Robert Young, Pia Sedora.
We're still waiting for people to settle in.
Get ready for the excitement, huh?
Yeah!
Started it all.
Hello!
Little
chairman of the Muscular Dystrophy Association, Jerry Lewis.
All right, thank you. Wow, have you been checking the Instagram? Have you been checking the stories at the moment? I'm going to read a poem. This is like ambient, so this is just a warm up and get everybody kind of settled in, and it's a quiet way to start the ritual. So this is called Music for Sleeping. Summer is June, July, August. Fall is September, October, November. Night of the blue super moon. Set your intentions. School starts tomorrow. I spent a lot of time uptown in the park. It was like it didn't happen. Night swimming with Philip. Really love your peaches, wanna shake your trees. Get me a suite of rooms, $2,500 a week. A new shirt every time I wear it. People will walk all over you. Or you'll just hold still, learning for adulthood. But it's already too late. Finding lyric sheets on the ground. Strangers keep me company. His cigarette smells like my grandpa's pipe, which reminds me of Carl Sandburg. The people, yes, that's open mic. Phone running out of battery, sitting right across from me, eating Magnolia Bakery and frozen yogurt, making 40 grand a year in my MFA program, where I'm paid to do it, 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 to do it. This is Woodstock 99, okay? Woo! I was reading an article about fucking Fred Durst on the way over, okay? So, douchebag culture is back, I guess. I don't know why I hated it. I hated it the first time. But it's cool. We're hardcore, okay? We're hardcore here in Easy Paradise. We're not like the snowflakes in the Republican primaries, okay? The snowflakes who are going to jail. Golf clubbed and bayoneted to death. Okay, so I want to do ASMR, so I'm going to whisper. I want to do whispering. This is whispering. Everybody just go to sleep. It's nap time. It's nap time. God bless Jimmy Buffett. I'm taking it hard. Jimmy, we love you. I'm a parrot head, okay? I'm sensitive. ASMR, don't they have like weird lip sounds and now they get me out. My feet feels like it's wet.
A free glass of Lafroy. That's right. Glass number 5 of Lafroy. It was at that moment that I knew I had made it. That's not really true. It was at that moment that I kind of blacked out. But later, when I woke up, I knew.
Red light, and this car pulled up next to us, and the guy rolls down his window, and he says to my father, "Hey, you really shouldn't blow smoke."
Without you, honey, oh, I can't tell the way you make my day. Each time that you call,
This one is called Pills Primary. Red Pills. Shoveling in the tart red seeds of a stolen winter pomegranate, racking up the years, the felonies. I didn't buy this. The dress is for a wedding, but not one that I'm going to. It was made for a girl in the early 80s with absolutely no boobs. The Minneapolitan who altered it to barely hold my bust was disappointed in my buying it off Depop for $35. The next day, in the pictures, the dress is shining and my eyeliner has suffered a great injustice.
category is Uncle Today Told Me This Piece of Advice. Have open eyes, have a critical eye. Fall in love after you're married, but don't tell the guy that. Let the stupid guy fall in love with you. And then,
advice.
Her cells are divided like fission. That's it. I think that's the. Thank you so much.
Green. Fallen leaves in the palms of many. A raindrop shivering on the tip of a lamb's ear. The gradient of a smoke tree's leaves, and seeking trust in the quality of your air. This year beckons us, my dear friend. Living things, the deepest sense of self, found like figs, lost like withered blossoms, but always to be found again in the turning seasons.
How you doing? I'm Matt. Thank you. This is called Nerf Togetherness. Summer is June, July, August. Fall is September, October, November. Night of the blue supermoon. Set your intentions. School starts tomorrow. I spent a lot of time uptown in the park. It was like it didn't happen. Night swimming with Philip. Really love your peaches. Want to shake your trees. Give me a suite of rooms, $2,500 a week. A new shirt every time I wear it. People will walk all over you. Or you'll just hold still, learning for adulthood, but it's already too late. Finding lyric sheets on the ground, strangers keep me company. His cigarette smells like my grandpa's pipe, which reminds me of Carl Sandburg, the people, yes. That's open mic. Phone running out of battery, sitting right across from me, eating Magnolia Bakery or frozen yogurt, making 40 grand a year in my MFA, where I'm paid for it, golf clubbed and bayoneted to death. Yorkville went berserk after that. My love in storage. I'll stay here till they kick me out. My feet feels like it's wet. Dropping the kids off at the pool, whole place to myself. Need to get the word out. Wait till I think of five things. Ruin these people's lives just because I moved into their houses. Essex, Hudson, Somerset. Attempting to land the plane by 1 a.m. Wish I had money to travel or do anything. Got kicked out of Rushmore Academy, painting badly looked at trees. Max Fisher would be on Twitch. Shipping myself into gigs, send me body airmail via submersible trains barreling into the metropolis. Sword of mouth. This weed makes me cry. I go in the side door, welcoming security. Three permissions, but who will I read it to? Thank you.
Hey, happy 50th Cafe Palermo. You're the cannoli king. You're the fucking cannoli king, huh? Cocksucker.
I look just like Rivers Cuomo.
Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the first annual Easy Paradise Labor Day Telethon. We have a million stars tonight. We are raising money for awareness. We have the return of Ashley Escobar. We have the return of Aiden Watson. We have Derek in the house. We have Obama Newton in the house. We have so many stars. Ladies and gentlemen, it's our tribute to Jimmy Buffett and all of the fallen heroes. Get ready. Here is your host, Mr. Easy Paradise. We have so much, we're going to raise so much money. We're going to talk about labor. No more labor, no more work. Where everybody's getting the day off forever. Automation is solving the labor crisis. The AI is going to work for us. We're going to be doing all the manual labor. Here's my impression of me if I was in the band The Mystic. That's my Misfits hair, right there. I know goddamn son of a bitch! You got that, all right. So yes, give yourselves a big round of applause, everybody. Thank you. We have 4 hours of entertainment. We all had off our weekend show. Signal was there. We have so much amazing stuff, but it's been a sad week. We have lost some of our elder artistic statesmen. So we just want to pay tribute. I mean, today, the news hit me very hard. I don't know about you guys, but I woke up. I looked at the New York Times. What do I see on the front page? Steve. Steve, the guy from Smash Mouth. I don't know what his last name is. He's dead. Another piece of the 90s is gone. I wonder how Rivers Cuomo feels today about it. He probably had an anxiety attack. He's like, oh my God, they're getting closer. It's my generation, it's Gen X now. So we're gonna pay tribute to Steve and we're gonna sing one of his favorite songs. You guys know it. Get ready, you can sing a song you want. So you sing it, you sing it. We know it, you saw Smash do in the shed. Come on, Steve, you're in heaven now. He lived in Boise, Idaho. He was a good man, he was on VH1. He was a part of our lives, whether we like him or not. Jimmy Buffett, I don't know why. You had to die. Did you win an Academy Award? Did you guys from Smash Mouth win an Academy Award? That was counting close. I'm a believer, right? They have so many hits. Walking up.
Right? They have so many hits. Walking on the sun, baby. Hey now, everybody, open mic. Easy Paradise, Monday night. Come on. Jerry Lewis Telethon. Give us money. I'm on Percocet, baby. I'm high on drugs. We're gonna have a wild show, baby. Hang on here. Josh Pano. Oh, baby, I loved it. I thought Smash Mouth was going to be the Doors. When they had that organ shit, okay. We love you, Steve. This is our tribute to you. Good night, sweet prince. Smash Mouth, play the county fair, baby. Play the Boise County Fair. 2,500 sellout, baby.
Celebrity Apprentice, baby. I'm about to see real life to feel the flavor. Alright. Okay, it's been tough. It's been tough. And we're just going to keep the tributes rolling.
Banquet, the same brewing
Jimmy Buffett would want the advertisements.
Start your legacy.
Easy Paradise, sponsored by Coors. So everybody, come on, drink it up. It's 5 o'clock in Easy Paradise, baby. We're having a good time. We're reading our poetry, babies.
We're reading our poetry, babies. New York City. I'm drinking a long neck bottle, baby. I'm from Columbus, Ohio. I'm raised on the tractor, baby. Alan Jackson, baby. I'm gonna hook it. I feel like I'm
just push me over. I'd like to call them something.
something's always wrong. Make it a hurricane before I go insane.
Oh, hey, baby, come on, Key West, Florida, tonight. We're gonna pull one out for Jimmy. We pull one out for Steve. Jerry Lewis in heaven, D-Mon. It's comedy, it's poetry. It's open mic, everybody. It's you.
It's lunch break.
Okay.
It's gonna take
you get it. That's it. That's all we have. That's our tribute. That's our tribute to fallen heroes. Huge artistic influences on me, my work. Yeah, it's easy. God, we have so many amazing acts. We have poetry, we have music, we have comedy. I can't wait to see. We have so many new faces. It's Labor Day. We have to get the day off, baby. We're all recharged. We're feeling 1,000%. And I do want to call to your attention, exactly 7 days from today is 9/11. So next week is our 9/11 show. Come out next week. Sign up early for that. And I'll just read a poem very quickly to just kind of close this out. And then we have a million stars. It's a night of a million stars. I mean, all the stars are here. So it's going to be magnificent. You're terrific. You're marvelous. You're a beautiful audience. Give yourself a big round of applause. Woo! Woo! Okay, this is cash only. The 6-7-8 plan is shallow and superficial. Brushing my teeth with my finger. Guess I'd better make 9 figures. Computerized announcer has a cold. One of the longest transfers in the system. Turning Ben Callahan into Gudrunstein Salon. Pronto. Freudian eruption. Funny Proust. Funny Kafka. Babysitting the crowd. Rent's due tomorrow. We're probably related. The bed bugs are drinking my blood. 2 on a match. Wearing a ping hat. Salesperson flying solo tells me she loves my style. Thanks, it's the drugs. My mom bought these clothes. I'm wearing sunglasses because I'm crying. What a loyal guy. I'm gonna work some Jerry Lewis stuff in, so be careful. I know it's terrible. People are like, what is this fucking Jerry Lewis Instagram stories? I don't want to see this. St. Mark's Church was my Rushmore. She's my Rushmore, Max. I know. She was mine, too. So feel free to use the stage to chew the scenery. We're going to have a rocking good time. Get ready for the telethon. We have so many stars. We're going to raise so much money for awareness. Speaking of which, let's get this first poet to kick us off. I could not imagine a better person to just ceremonially introduce us to the night. Give it up for the great Galvin, everybody. Galvin.
So when I heard that the dude from Smash Mouth died today, I thought my girlfriend was just fucking with me. Thought it was a joke. You guys know the comedian Chris Fleming? Any fans?
Yeah.
So he's my favorite comedian. I got to interview him one time, and one of my questions was, so if like the dude from Smash Mouth died, who would replace him? And he said Jared Kushner. Anyway,
I cannot deny myself nutrients. I want to nibble and be nibbled. I don't want anyone to break a tooth on my body. They eat their hunger. Hunger eats me. Woo!
How many of us are rich?
It's awful. 17 years? How old are you?
I'm old as shit.
You're doing a math. You made the weirdest faces no one ever sees. Weirdest faces no one ever sees.
Thank you.
And Thinking Matt, doing your thing.
Give it up for Derek, give it up for all the stars, Joe Briggs, Claire Donaher, Jack Barth, Mary Jane, James Brown. Give it up for Amanda the bartender. We are done. Get out of here, Pasta Boy. The Weezer Cruise is my midlife crisis. Luma Spicy named his daughter after his favorite coding language. I don't want to do anything hard. How's this for arts and crafts? War is the most avant-garde. My phone overheated from playing Weezer. Join us Saturday. I'm doing an hour. I'm doing an hour at Young Ethel's. I'm doing so much. So thank you all for coming out. Get home safe. We had a great telethon. Happy Labor Day, James Brown. Happy Labor Day, Houts. Happy Labor Day. Sounded great.
Right.
It was the first guy on heroin who said that exactly.
No big deal,
no
man.
No big deal, baby.
Just everyone should try it.
Everyone's doing it. It's great.
Yeah. What?
Big fat cannoli to shove in your mouth.
Yeah, right. Is that in the song?
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah. He's like, she's waiting for you with the fire in her eyes and a big fat cannoli to shove in your mouth.
Which song is that?
Thank God for girls.
Where's the video? That is nice. We'll have to make a music video with this because that can be our... Should we do that in the play?
Should we do the cannoli thing?
Yeah.
I don't know if I can eat that many, but...
I'd be like, Rivers, I have cannoli
you
for you.
You can eat it once, or...?
You can.
We're gonna have carb it now, and... carb it later. Oh, I've got some of my... print it. Birthday cup. I got my birthday in 2017 when I was 32. The 30th annual awards dinner. So I'm older than Columbia Daily Spectator. Okay, that's enough.
Thank you, Julian. Our next reader is going to be Matt Proctor. Matt is the host of Easy Paradise Open Mic every Monday night at the KGB Red Room in the East Village. His poetry reality show, Scenes from a Life, airs Mondays at 11 p.m. on Manhattan Public Access Television and anytime on YouTube. Please welcome Matt to the reading.
Thank you. Thank you, Ashley. Thank you so much for having me, Ashley. Thank you for the invitation. And thank you for the Brooklyn Rail. I'm just going to read from my Cosmopolitan Micro Diaries. Can you hear me? Okay. 8:31, Catcher in the Rye. Summer is June, July, August. Fall is September, October, November. Night of the blue supermoon. Set your intentions. School starts tomorrow. I spent a lot of time uptown in the park. It was like it didn't happen. Night swimming with Philip. Really love your beaches. Want to shake your trees. Get me a suite of rooms, $2,500 a week. A new shirt every time I wear it. People will walk all over you, or you'll just hold still, learning for adulthood, but it's always too late. Finding lyric sheets on the ground. Strangers keep me company. His cigarette smells like my grandpa's pipe tobacco, which reminds me of Carl Sandburg. The people, yes, that's open mic. Phone running out of battery, sitting right across from me, eating Magnolia Bakery or frozen yogurt, making 40 grand a year in my MFA where I'm paid for it, golf clubbed and bayoneted to death. Yorkville went berserk after that. My love and storage, I'll stay here till they kick me out. My feet feels like it's wet, dropping the kids off at the pool, whole place to myself. Need to get the word out. Wait till I think of five things. Ruin these people's lives just because I moved into their houses. Essex, Hudson, Somerset, attempting to land the plane by 1 a.m. I wish I had money to travel or do anything. Got kicked out of Rushmore, painting badly looked at trees. Max Fisher would be on Twitch. Shipping myself into gigs, sending my body airmail via submersible trains, barreling into the metropolis by sword of mouth. This weed makes me cry. I go in the side door, welcoming security. Three permissions rather make one, but who will I read it to? 8-5, unisex. Pack a bowl. Ashley washed her bangs. Philip saw Weezer at Central Park Summer Stage sometime around the release of the Blue album. Pitchfork was so wrong. Every Weezer album should be on Pin Sound. I give it a 10. It's about information, Marty. Amusement parks of super wealth, everywhere becoming the same place. Noah was there when they did the interview. Eddie likes his queer epic, addicted to music, earbuds in all the way. Richard Dutton, Shakespeare professor, gives me a C+ on my paper. They didn't tag me in any of the photos, like a blanket on my life. Heard Saroyan for Yossarian. The ball is always in play. Annalisa used to live downstairs. Then she showed up in my restaurant in Midtown. Forest Plaza emptying the loneliness. Out to get me, gunning for me. She sat next to me without moving. My leg touching her bag the whole time. 9-2. Cash only. The 6-7-8 plan is shallow and superficial. Brushing my teeth with my finger, guess I better make nine figures. Computerized announcer has a cold, one of the longest transfers in the system. Turning Ben Callahan into Gertrude Stein Salon pronto. Freudian eruptions, funny Proust, funny Kafka. Babysitting the crowd, rent's due tomorrow. We're probably related. The bedbugs are drinking my blood, two on a match, wearing a ping hat. Salesperson at Flying Solo tells me she loves my style. Thanks. It's the drugs. My mom bought me these clothes. I wear sunglasses because I'm crying. What I do for a living. St. Mark's Church, she's my Rushmore, Max. I know. She was mine, too. 8:25. Is life real? The astronauts could take one tape with them to space. Most of them chose country and Western music. We need a new solution, one which cybernetics can provide. The firm brain for the unforeseeable future. No future is foreseeable for diplomatic reasons. My tooth hurts. My dad's brother. My dad's dad. His dad's dad, all his brothers, all were house painters. Painting walls and ceilings, minimalist white. 3 hours a day, smoking weed, taking lunch. Painting the Sistine Chapel ceiling white, laying on their back on a scaffold. Switched on proc, looking for a dime. Praying for the inevitable Eno-Weezer collaboration in heaven. 8:16, Hormone Garage. Babysitting adults, corporate people, myopic Imperial Rashomon cameras, making the journey to KGB to hang flyers and Jada's open mic. I'll be in the house on my day off. Listening to Weezer has made my orgasms even better. You are sacred to me. Metronomes, inner ear monitors, getting in state. Jason Schwartzman and Wes Anderson bonded over Pinkerton on the set of Rushmore. That's the most fucked up thing I've ever heard. 817, Ecce Homo. Dry cleaning bill, proof of adult, Supermax USA. This thing is not working. She gave me a BJ with a golf pencil. These are her dogs. The winds are in full sail, becoming unison. I want that down here. Power grab, cash grab, grab ass. We're almost there, but not quite. Coming pre-fragmented, that meaning should be titled meaning. The Weezer effect. When a song comes out and everybody thinks it sucks for 15 years, but later realize collectively it was a masterpiece the whole time. Potzers making the Green Day video, screaming over the backing track when I should have been lip syncing. Nikki Foley had a copy of the tape, large spectacle theater, booking and arranging flanks of artists and Mr. Show's class before the camcorder, writing speculative fiction about theater people. Quick nine at pop-up putting green on Avenue A. Paul Stewart is a good menswear brand, Ingrid tells me. Her mom plays bagpipes and may come to the open mic with them. A12, big and greedy. Ashley's roommate was shot at 4 times on the way home. First thing Ashley's birthday, just after midnight. Luckily, she was unharmed. Big and greedy, Scottie Pippen to Larry Bird. Nice to me because she thinks I'm a professor at Columbia, which I kind of am. $30 for 2/8 and a pre-roll. $8 for suave new camel hair coat from Mission on Upper West Side. First new blazer since open mic started. Fits well. I'm carrying it in a paper bag. Smittick and Sons. Goober Grape had peanut butter and jelly in the same jar. The Upanishads of walking around doing nothing, which I should have had for myself. But how could I stop you? Women who love me don't care about my boundaries. This is not a bit. Didn't get into summer camp. I was awake, but I was asleep, wandering through nature in Central Park like Tony Bennett, reading a book, getting high by the Alice statue. Guess who's moving back to New York? That's what I'm afraid of. Mom will be so pleased. Lantern bugs unfurling red scrolls on my stomach and sidewalk. It's a paid gig. Can't afford to say no. Where we shot our album cover, which is what people always say about bad pictures. My future's in my past. Short attention span theater. Gulping Mariana's Trench for her birthday. I give her me as a present all week. Staring at me while I sleep. There's a mouse by my feet. Graduating from Harvard, summa cum laude. Come harder, eminent domain, proprioceptive hovercraft, sloppy, ugly work, la Donny Mobile, never giving back, afraid to let anything go, including credit card transaction fee, a percentage the banks and credit card companies tacked on, watching Malinoche and Dangerous Game, watching people play tennis, multitudes of courts with waitlists, JFK Jr., Go Andy Roddick, and the New York City blackout of 2003, when TRL broadcast live every day from Times Square, the Spanish police commissioner riding by on a pedicab. Eric Adams lives in New Jersey, sitting on this green bench in Central Park in my new camel hair blazer is the poem I want to write. He saw it again for the first time 40 short years later, lying on a floaty TRL hosted by Carson Daly. If I hadn't been rudely interrupted, scarfing Cornish hen on the corner of 2nd Avenue and 62nd Street, the open mic's canceled, so they gave me my money back. And then I just have a couple more short pieces. 8/11, down and out in high school. Yeah, sorry for all the Weezer references. It's been a Weezer kind of summer. So down and out in high school. Ashley puked, choking on my dick. We changed the sheets and I came on her tits. Happy birthday, Ashley. I need a new everything. Obama lived on this street. So did Robert Duvall and Dustin Hoffman. Now it's us. Receiving direct transmissions, but it's not my house. Jim Burley used a dog sit for Eileen Miles, says we could break into the building. Gives Ashley the Blue album on vinyl and John Wiener's selected poems for her birthday. We watch Dangerous Game and Malinoche. Harvey Keitel is charismatic in a deranged way, honing in on the psychotic zone of Bad Lieutenant. His Raphaelite bob and split nose give the film a Renaissance feel, like he's wearing the mask of Red Death as they torture Madonna with a knife. I drop my phone, causing it to overheat. Brooklyn Poets hate me, taping Mon Oncle off Turner Classic Movies at 2 a.m. Friday night, when they showed foreign films, Fassbender, Berlin Alexanderplatz, Chantel Ackerman, Golden 80s, writings on film, I often wax poetic about music. My grandpa Jacques Tati in a gentle choreography of automobiles, banned from the island after congestion pricing. And this will be my last one. Thank you again for having me. Come out to Easy Paradise open mic Monday at KGB Bar. 813 shortcut. Walking to town, lowering the bar, a has-been. Anything could happen by the clean is the song that plays when you die as the end credits roll over your life. Thank you.
Thanks, Matt.
The MCR fan thing.
It's like something like something very emo, like
yeah.
Something like.
Right.
Know.
Something very emo, but you won a Scholastic Award for your MCR fanfic. Yeah. That was your first writing prize.
Actually, no, it wasn't.
Oh, really? Okay.
I also have this cute green dress that I got when I was back in
California. Oh, okay.
I just forgot.
9/11. There's a rainbow in the sky on 9/11.
Who got that hydro? Who got that light green? Who got that Bobby Brown? Who got that Latin weed?
All right, Easy Paradise open mic. We have got the Bin Laden weed. We are here in New York City, baby, downtown New York. Give it up for Easy Paradise Monday. We have so much entertainment. We have the goods tonight, everybody. We have good energy. We're going to bring healing. We're never going to forget. We're not going to talk about 9/11 that much. But there's going to be a little 9/11 content, okay? We're going to start out with a little investigation, just a tribute. This is one of my favorite, the subgenre of
low carb.
Easy Paradise is sponsored by Low Carb, More Taste
of Light Beer.
Michelob Light, everybody, the next generation of light beer. Sing along if you remember it. Come on, the Super Bowl 22. McCartney, jingoistic, patriotic, warlike anthem. I never thought McCartney would do it. I never thought McCartney would be a war hawk. We want to give Ireland back to the Irish. Talking about freedom. Come on, everybody, you remember? Talking about freedom. You must fight. All right. Swag rock. This is like a swag rock anthem. McCartney invented it. I'm Paul McCartney. You have to answer, man. We're gonna go to Afghanistan. We're gonna get Bin Laden, man. We're gonna kill him, man. We're gonna find him. We're gonna put him in Guantanamo Bay, man. Like I saw in the Patriot Act, man. If John was alive, he'd be like, fuck Al Qaeda. Come on. All right, I know this is in bad taste. We're just, remember this? It was horrible. Some of you weren't alive. Most of you were infants, so you have to know this is what it was like. Tom Brady is in the Super Bowl. McCartney saving democracy. America, fuck yeah, sock. Talking about freedom. Talking about freedom. God, I'm crying. I am crying. Liverpool, all you need is love. Give peace a chance, and we're gonna kick Bin Laden's ass. All right, so sorry, but the tour's almost over. We just have one more. This is the warm up. I'm breaking the ice. We need to talk about it. Okay, we were gonna do Femcel 9/11.
American girls,
you know it.
American guys,
oh yeah, baby. Sing along, baby. You know the fucking words.
Recognize
when we see old glory.
There's a lot of
men dead.
So we
fucking sleep at peace, and now when we lay down our
head. My daddy served in the army till the day that he died. Till the day that he died.
My brother, you people, open micers, he died. Toby Keith died to protect your open mic.
Now this nation that love is falling
under attack.
Sitting up, flying in from somewhere in the back. As soon as we can see
your door,
through our big black eye.
Gonna light up your sky.
Like the 4th of July.
And Uncle Sam got his name at the top of his list. And the Statue of Liberty shaking her fist. It's gonna be a hell to pay.
And it's gonna be here.
But there you go. Freedom, 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 United States. War on terrorism. We defeated terrorism here tonight.
Brought to you courtesy of the
red, white, and blue. America, baby! Toby's taking home, brother.
Well, Uncle Sam, just as
America, George W. Bush, Dick Cheney, venture capitals, Halliburton, Enron, the crash. 20 years, 20 fucking years in Afghanistan, baby. I feel bad.
The USA.
We'll put a boot in your ass. It's the American way. And Uncle Sam got his name out the top of your list. Uncle Sam, shake it, 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 shake it. Eagle will fly. I love freedom. I'm the First Amendment. I love the Second Amendment, baby. Guns, 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 American guns. Defend our country. Defend our country. Defending New York City, baby. Hey, it hasn't happened again. Fool me once. Fool me once. It hasn't happened again, baby. God bless America. God bless you. God bless Easy Paradise.
All right. We are going to defeat terrorism tonight.
Here I go again on my own. Okay. All right. So we are defeating terrorism tonight. Thank you all for coming out. I apologize for how insensitive that display of patriotism and pride, national pride. I never forgot. I had a fucking World Trade Center mural painted in the back of my Ford F-150. That's how much I care. No, but I hope you're doing okay. I hope you had a good day. And we're here for the healing. You can talk. You don't have to talk about 9/11, but it's 9/11. So I just God damn, those songs were all over the radio, and they're propaganda. So we just want to expose the lies. We're exposing the lies tonight, okay? We're going to tell the truth about 9/11. We've got the microphone. You come up, you tell your truth. You know, we're going to blow the lid on this thing. So, yeah, exactly. We're here. We've got so much power. We're on YouTube. They haven't banned us yet. Maybe tonight they will, but we'll see. You come out, you say whatever you want, okay? We died protecting your First Amendment rights here for the open mic. So thank you, and it's going to be beautiful. Poetry, comedy, and music as we've experienced so far. So it is a 2-drink minimum for everybody. It's a 5-minute time limit per performer. We got a lot of amazing acts. Thanks for coming out to the Red Room. This first act, one of our favorites here at KGB Open Mic Monday. He is a New Yorker through and through. Give it up for Angel Lugo. Angel Lugo, the BK native. Get ready for these sick beats and the freestyle.
If tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd work for all my life, and I had to start again.
We did it, 9/11 is over. Yay, we're free. We won. We fucking won. We're going into, okay, 9/11 was an inside job. I'm going to tell the truth, it was an inside job. I did a short film. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I'm proud to be an American, fucking ends America. And I'm proud to stand up
next to you
here well today.
Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land.
God bless the USA. Come on. 9/11 was an inside job, okay? If Al Gore had won the election, if George W. Bush's fucking brother wasn't the governor of Florida, we're going in the pasta void. Take me away, all right? Take me away. Throw me in Guantanamo Bay. I don't give a shit. 9/11 ruined my life. It ruined the millennials, man. We're clinically depressed. We fucking... The Weezer Cruise is my midlife crisis. Loomis Spicy, Lee Greenwood, we love America. This stolen fucking...
And it's time we stand and
I don't want to do anything hard.
And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. I'm proud to live in this fucking stolen country, watching Monday Night Football, Hank Williams just stand up next to you. New World Trade, second plane. What else do I have to say?
No doubt, I love
this land. God bless the USA. Fucking love the greatest country in the world! The greatest country alive, number one, bitch! This thing, we will beat your ass! 800 billion military! We'll fucking crush you!
Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land!
Fuck Al Qaeda!
God bless the USA!
We killed Bin Laden.
All right. Yeah.
Matt Proctor, everybody.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah.
You just never know. You never fucking know. Now the Weezer play.
Anything that sucks, you kept
referring to as coitus in italics.
I
was like, this is so
dirty.
Is that Latin?
I guess.
Latin,
like, okay.
Oh, I'll make it up to you, and I'll take photos of you guys when you're doing your reply.
Oh.
Okay, so this is a play that I wrote based on the life of Rivers Cuomo. Rivers Cuomo, the lead singer for the band Weezer from the 90s. So this takes place, it's kind of a niche piece. I was influenced by like Kevin Killian plays where he has celebrities and stuff. So this is sort of like, it takes place on the Weezer cruise. That's kind of the most important thing you need to know. The Weezer cruise was a real thing they did. Their band sold a bunch of tickets for a cruise. Dinosaur Jr. was on it, and they played gigs on the cruise, and they had trivia, and Weezer was there. You could go visit with Weezer. And so they've done it twice. This is the third Weezer cruise. So it takes place deep in River Stateroom on the Weezer cruise.
Just one second.
the damnedest thing. One night, out under the stars, I heard a sound off in the distance. And I stood there as it got louder and louder until I realized it was a song. A beautiful song. A song I'd never heard before. So I threw it in the old Shazam. And wouldn't you know it, it was Opening Night by Weezer. Weezer, I know, but it was too late. I don't know what it was, but I was hooked, obsessed, driven to find out everything I could about their music. The Red Album, Maljoy, Hurley. I couldn't believe my ears. This incredible music, it's not what I remembered listening to or reading about in reviews. So then I turned on to later stuff. Pacific Daydream, the Black Album, the White Album, the California Trilogy. Do not sleep on the California Trilogy. I was startled, shocked. I had this brilliance, this, dare I say, genius. Been hiding in plain sight all this time. The way rivers can write melody and lyrics with equal and sympathetic ingeniousness, there's not a lot of people who can do that. He may be the most gifted songwriter of my generation. He could be, but I can't help but think he's wasting his talents. Maybe it's not too late.
Seriously, who is this? Is this some weird fan harassment? This is not funny.
You're tempting fate, Rivers. You should not have taken the third cruise. You're getting tired. You're getting manic. Weezer cruise will go down like the Titanic.
This is a hallucination. This is a rock and roll hallucination. This is like a fucking acid flashback or like a Molly relapse or something.
It's David Rivers.
David Geffen?
No, David Berman.
You better explain who you are in about 5 seconds or I will security all lead a smackdown in your ass, bro!
I was in a band called the Silver Jews.
Okay.
We had a couple albums in the 90s, the 2000s. We got our start in New York. We started off with Steve Malkmus.
You know Malkmus?
Yeah, we were security guards to Whitney together.
I've never heard of you.
Have you heard of Pitchfork? Because our album, American Water, got a 9.4 on Pitchfork.
9.4? Pitchfork hates Weezer. You know, we haven't got above a 5 since the 90s. What was your band called again?
Silver Jews.
Silver Jews?
Yeah, I'm tired of this one.
Pavement is pretty cool.
You like Pavement. I took you for more of a Green Day.
Green Day rocks, dude. I mean, fuck, we just got up the Hella Mega Tour with Green Day and Fall Out Boy.
Hella Mega Tour, huh?
We're doing stadiums.
I got a question. Cho-Cho San, I thought that was like some kind of avant-garde Japanese musician by Ryuichi Sakamoto or something. What is that?
It's from Madam Butterfly.
Madam Butterfly, that's right. Harvard Grant over here. No, I went to UVA. UMass Amherst, state schools, college game day. alleyways and dumpsters full of beer.
We play a lot of state schools.
There's, why can't you make another album? Like, what was the first one called? The new one.
Yeah.
Yeah, what's the name of that?
It's called Blue Out.
It's called Blue Out.
Yeah.
Yeah, Blue Out's a good album. I like the song. What's the song about Kiss on it?
In the Garage.
In the Garage, that's a good song.
Yeah,
I think we're both metalheads. I saw Stryker in Dallas once.
Dude, I saw Stryker in Rochester in 84, man. I saw Winger in New Haven 87.
I'm sorry, Winger sucks.
Dude, Winger kicks ass, okay? Their Spotify playlist, what Rivers was listening to, 80, 81, 82, 83, 84.
Oh, fuck your playlist. You know, that's why I had to die. You're like part computer. I'm a Civil War general.
I teach programming at Harvard, yes.
All these fucking algorithms, that's not, it's not music. Sometimes you just gotta leave on helm that shit.
That's what we did on Ratitude.
I like Ratitude. Sick cover, too.
Thanks, man. Not a lot of people did. I got a 3.6 on Pitchfork.
Yeah, look, I like your music, Rivers, but I'm here to tell you, you're not reaching your potential. You're complicit. It's the kidification of adulthood. Weezer cruise, for Christ's sake. Water slides, Muppets. How old are you? 50? Act like an adult.
No offense, but you're dead.
Yeah, a lot of us are dead. Because we were artists. That's what killed us.
I stopped believing in the myth of the self-destructing artist after making the leap.
You know, Malcolmus and Thurston, those guys, they don't take you seriously. You should hear what Frank Black says about you behind your back. To them, you're a joke. A nerd band with weaves. You know, maybe Beck likes you. Or you know what? Dave Grohl.
Hey, Dave is a nice guy, okay? And while we could have flamed out early, Foo Fighters and Weezer have been making kick-ass rock music for 30 years. I mean, we're on the Weezer cruise right now. Where's your cruise, bro? I think that's pretty cool. No offense, but who are you again? I mean, I've barely heard of your band. Like, Weezer, statistically speaking, is the 340th most listened to artist in the world on Spotify.
You need to dig deeper, Rivers. But it might already be too late.
Wait a minute, man. Who are you? You're not him. You're not that guy.
He left the door unlocked.
You shouldn't be in here.
Please, Rivers, just 5 minutes. My name's Erie. I'm on your Discord server.
It's not a good time.
Please, why don't you play anything off Black Album Live?
You like the Black Album?
Yeah, I love the Black Album, Pacific Daydream, White Album, the entire California trilogy.
You don't hate him like Pitchfork?
Pitchfork's for millennials.
You can stay for 5 minutes.
Thank you so much. So are you fine with this being on the record?
Sure, yeah.
Okay. So it's been reported that you took a 2-year vow of celibacy before your marriage. Why did you do that?
That's kind of personal. Look, it was part of the meditation regimen I was going through. You know, resisting desires, you see them fall away. Not being overstimulated can sharpen your mind, which can help with songwriting.
Do you see yourself as a progenitor of insult culture, or that Pinkerton or Blue Album could represent negative stereotypes about masculinity?
Our second album was ultimately too personal and revealing. I wanted to take the audience to dark places that should have remained hidden.
But you still play songs from Pinkerton live.
That's what people like.
Why don't you make another album as horny as that?
You said it was toxic.
No, I said it could represent negative stereotypes of toxic masculinity.
You get older, your body changes. You know, I'm not as horny as I was. You know, I'm a father now, I have kids. You work for college, a newspaper? Or?
No, college radio.
They still have that?
Yeah, Bennington they do. We're ranked number 14 on the best college radio stations by the Princeton Review.
So why do you use spreadsheets to make music?
That's kind of overblown. I keep a directory of lyrics in Excel where I have things arranged. What are you doing? Things arranged by syllable? What is that? What is that? No. You have to ask permission first.
No, I don't. In New York State, we have a law called single party consent.
That sounds like you just made it up.
No, I didn't, Burgers. As long as one of the participants consents, including myself, filming any conversation is legal. Without release forms.
Look, this is the Weezer cruise, okay? We're subject to maritime law. This is not New York State.
No, I'm not a lawyer. Look, everyone's been criticizing you because you talk about California too much in your music. You're becoming like the Beach Boys, except you're not the Beach Boys. You're just talking about ocean, surfing, California. Except you add this weird dystopian way of like incorporating tech culture, like you're climbing up a tower, but you also have a computer, and it's like, why, Burgers?
That all's dope. That's all dope shit. You sound like a fader write-up, dude.
I mean, I was a teen music blogger.
I work with Post Malone, okay? We're working on a track together, okay? I'm in there with Olivia Rodrigo, okay? What did you ever do with your life?
I wrote for a rookie magazine.
You know Tabby?
Yeah, I do.
Dude, she's in all these plays. She's legit as hell. She's in all these. I love outdoor Shakespeare. That's my thing. I go to all these outdoor Shakespeare plays. I love Hamlet and Romeo and Juliet and.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Well, it's interesting because like I was trying to find you before your last show, and instead of seeing Shakespeare, you were like, busy playing pickleball.
The guys in the band, they're not so into the Shakespeare plays. They like pickleball. It's fun to do on tour, you know. And the Weezer, we got a pickleball.
Okay. Well, I was wondering, there's a playlist where you talk about your favorite like catchy songs, but it feels like Summer's on it, but not, what's the one? Living in L.A.
You just said you don't like the California songs.
No, I love the California song, but I'm just wondering why you can't write about anything besides California.
It's where I live. I love California, and it's like, it's a branding mechanism, really. it's like the Beach Boys. Like
Weezer invented LA.
The Beach Boys invented LA. I love the Beach Boys. I love Brian Wilson. I was listening to this Beach Boys tape that I had when I was writing the songs for the Blue Album, and Pet Sounds. Mm-hmm. It's huge influence. The Weezer is really just the Beach Boys, but with the guitars turned. And like metal.
Okay, do you go surfing at all?
I'm not good with water. I don't really like water.
Well, the most important question is, what do you like on your salad?
I get this amazing salad every day.
Rivers.
Who is it?
Brian.
I'm Brian.
Not interrupting anyone.
Dude, she works for college radio.
No way.
Way.
I remember college radio.
Back in the 1900s.
Back in the previous millennium.
Before you were probably even alive.
Oh, hey, you know what? That's why I'm here. Speaking of the previous millennium, how would you like to see a screen of James Cameron's 1997 cinematic masterpiece, Titanic? They're showing it up on the forecastle.
The what?
The forecastle. It's like near the poop deck. Where we play pickleball yesterday.
I would love to watch Titanic near the poop deck where we played pickleball yesterday. It's one of my favorite movies of all time.
Cool. It's a date. I'll see you guys up there. It was nice meeting you.
Erie.
Erie, like the lake.
More like Ashley Erie, you know that brand that Rivers has to shop at because they make clothing for short people.
See you guys
out there. Thanks, man. Yeah, you heard the man. I gotta go to this Titanic screen.
No, but I have a few questions.
No. Please don't make this uncomfortable for me. Please.
Please, Rivers.
No. Don't touch me. Don't touch Rivers. Please.
Please.
No. I remember you. I remember you from the Discord server. You were banned.
Rivers, that was in high school.
No. You're not supposed to be here. We had you on a list of psychotic fans
no.
because you're too upset.
Rivers, you don't get it. Matt.
No, we have a no tolerance policy when it comes to making friends. You You scare the dog. You scare gratitude dogs.
Yes.
Are you for fucking... You're gonna fucking... Shut up with that fucking
dog. Look, I don't want to do this for you.
Look, don't kill me. Please. Please don't kill me.
I mean, I don't want to. You're one of our greatest living Gen X songwriters.
Great. Let's write a song together.
Late.
No. I mean. What do you want to write a song about? Write a song about anything. Sweaters.
Let's write a song about love.
Love, classic. Classic subject for Weezer. Let me get my spreadsheets.
No spreadsheets. Just you and the guitar.
Off the dome. Great. What do you want to write a song about?
I want you to write a song about me.
Great, okay. Eerie. That's a good name for a song, actually.
Really?
Yeah, there's a lot of rhymes.
You mean it?
Yeah, eerie. Just wanna get bleeding. I want you to be near me. Please just don't kill me. Right? That on the next album. The demos, maybe.
Iceberg, straight ahead!
Max! The Weezer Cruise is going down! The Weezer Cruise is going down! Oh, I am slain!
Bodies sewn head to toe, toe to head, between a scream of blanket.
What lies behind that door?
But you already know.
I do?
Yes.
How come?
That's what you do,
right? This grilled place was really good. I had a sandwich there beforehand. Wow. It really hit the spot.
I haven't eaten since 11 a.m.
Oh my god. You need to eat, actually. You got your amp and everything? You sure?
Ben Anastas' memoir, quoting The Great Gatsby. Not a purgatory in Bushwick.
Okay, yeah.
And yeah, because his friend was awesome. He's like a music photographer. Like, he drove all the way to meet us and, like, he drove us home.
a pretty dope ass movie theater, really. You know? We could do an evening of readings, and that's kind of what I want to get into. Like, I want to get into like hybrid.
We found again the diamond light after the castanet girl finishes her dance, after the gold melts a little more each day, and the mandolin, the high flute, and the deliberate violin are in your ears. Did you hear them tonight? And this one's called John. I threatened to drive everyone under the geyser at Echo Park. In a white swan, thought we would drown. Sometimes I'm evil like that. Slept on the hazelnut floor next door to Hockney's pool, overshadowed by poplar trees. We were a school of fish, fish in an island miles away.
I wore clothes when I get there. It was our last album, so we played on a roof, entering a sacrosanct pact with never appearing live again. It was the last night it ever happened. Take my word for it. She's not innocent, and a meanness has entered her face.
Protesting Marc Jacobs, goddamn it. Fuck you, Marc Jacobs. I agree. His bookstore kind of... He needs more literature. He needs more poetry. I'm the... Jacobs, with blood on his hands.
Shame on you for what you do.
Shame on you for what you do.
Shame on you for what you do.
Where the hell is your compassion?
Where the hell is your compassion?
Shame on you for what?
I mean, you do have the Lost in Translation t-shirt. They could sign that. She could sign that. Get crypto rich. It's the only way we could get that rich that fast.
So you're saying that I can't do this? No, I guess I can't know.
Prairie.
You can aim higher. Oh, no more phone.
The heroic library.
Yeah, they crowd.
All these fucking scaffolds. Before the leaves fall. Before the autumn leaves fall. They care if I roll a joint? Huh?